in your top cognitive function stack, you have either introverted thinking and extroverted feeling, or you have extroverted thinking and introverted feeling. In some order and in some location in your cognitive function stack, you have those. You have two of those functions. And today I want to talk about those of us who have the introverted feeling and extroverted thinking axis, okay? So we're talking about those who have either extroverted thinking in first, second, third, or fourth slot, and introverted feeling in first, second, third, or fourth slot. And so you're looking at ISFPs and INFPs, ESTJs and ENTJs. And then it would also be the ISTJ, INTJ, and the ENFP, ESFPs. If you have these two cognitive functions, then you don't have introverted thinking and extroverted feeling. And if you're still trying to figure out which of those two axes do I have in my top cognitive function stack, well, that is a discussion for a different video. I'm not going to be talking about that in this video. But what I do want to talk about is for those of you who know that you have FITE or TEFI, however you want to look at it, how can you tell if you favor your extroverted thinking over your introverted feeling or vice versa? Now, this is not going to be an exhaustive video on that topic because there are numerous ways that a person can determine if he or she favors TE over FI or FI over TE. But I want to talk about one observation from my own life that I find to be rather informative. So I was discussing one time with an ESTJ why she decides to drive the route that she drives when she has to go someplace. And she said, not surprisingly for someone who favors TE, especially all the way at the top, she said, I go the way that is the most efficient or the fastest route to get there. Now, that is in stark contrast to the decision-making that leads me to go the route that I go when I have to drive somewhere. And this has come in to play heavily now that I have been doing DoorDash for the last 3 or 4 months, however long it's been. So whenever I drive somewhere, just in general, okay, so forget about when I'm DoorDashing and trying to make money. When I just need to get from point A to point B, I go the route that I enjoy the most. Now, that route oftentimes is not the fastest route. It's not the most efficient route. It tends to either be the more scenic route, which I enjoy, or it just has a stretch of road that I like a lot, or it has scenery or buildings along the way that I like a lot. And I rarely focus in on whether or not the direction, the roads that I'm taking are the most efficient or the fastest. Now, this has come into play heavily in my door dashing because let's say that I am at point A and I get an order from DoorDash to go to restaurant B, okay? Now, restaurant B, there is in such a place that there is a, as is always the case anytime you're going anywhere, there is a most direct route. However, I don't like that route. I like to go a different way. And were I not door dashing, were I just going there for my own leisure, I would go the other way. And when I first started door dashing, that's what I did. I was going the route that I enjoyed going the most. It wasn't always the fastest, but it was the most enjoyable to me. Then when I had to go to the home after picking up the food, same thing. There's the fastest, most efficient way, and then there's the way that I like to go. And then after I've dropped off the food, perhaps I'm close to other restaurants and can just kind of park and sit there and wait for another order. Or maybe I'm some distance from where there are any restaurants, and so I'm going to go to an area where there are restaurants where I might potentially get an order. I again have the decision, do I want to drive the most efficient way or do I want to drive the way that I enjoy going? Now, when I was first DoorDashing for the first few weeks, I found that I continued to go to the restaurants, to the homes, and back from the homes Taking the routes that I found to be the most pleasant, but not necessarily the most efficient. But as time went on and I looked at my numbers, I was looking at the amount of money that I was making versus the amount of mileage that I was driving, the time that I was spending doing DoorDash in order to make those dollars, I was finding that in the numbers, I could see that my route decision making was impacting me negatively as it came to making the most money in the least amount of time for the fewest dollars. Now, to someone who favors extroverted thinking over introverted feeling, this would be so obvious. Someone who favors extroverted thinking would not even consider, especially in an environment where the goal is to make money in the most efficient way possible. The person who favors the extroverted thinking would never even consider going the least efficient way or a less efficient way because he or she likes it better. The high extroverted thinking person is going to default to, I must go the way that is the most efficient, that is the quickest, that is the fewest miles for the sake of getting the thing done in the best way possible. And the person who favors extroverted thinking is not going to be too tempted to divert from that concept for the sake of, oh, but I like this better. Oh, but this makes me happier. Oh, but this is more pleasant. Those considerations will be subject to the consideration of what is the fastest, most effective, most efficient way. But that is not what I was doing early on. I was defaulting to my natural introverted feeling that says, do what you like. Do what makes you feel good. Do what makes you happy. Do what you find to be the most pleasant. In my situation, the extroverted thinking being efficient and effective was subject to the introverted feeling's desire to do what it liked. Now, as an introverted feeling dominant person, I had to really analyze the cost of allowing my natural brain wiring to control what I was doing. And when it came down to, you know, the nuts and bolts of the situation, I had to flip the script, basically. I had to force my introverted feeling to be subject to the extroverted thinking and start always taking the most direct route, the most efficient and effective way, regardless of whether I liked it, regardless of whether I found it pleasant or enjoyable, regardless of whether it was my favorite road, regardless of whether there was any good scenery, any of those things. I had to subject all of that to the extroverted thinking's, logic of, hey, let's get this thing done in the most effective way. And what I found was, not shocking, the numbers began to trend better for me, making more money in less time and driving fewer miles. Now, this would never surprise someone who favors their extroverted thinking over their introverted feeling. That would be like a, yeah, duh moment for them. But for the introverted feeling dominant person, it takes some work to constrain that introverted feeling and force it to be subject to the extroverted thinking's way of doing things. Now, I will say, for the IJs and the EPs, this will not be as big of a battle. So even for, let's say, an ENFP or ESFP that has FI over the TE, yes, they will still tend to want to default to the introverted feeling's way of doing things, but they're more balanced, so they will not subjugate extroverted thinking to introverted feeling to the point of detriment or peril. They're going to have some common sense in this area and say, yeah, I do like this thing better, but obviously the right thing to do is the extroverted thinking way of doing it. And on the IJ side, the extroverted thinking is already slightly more dominant than the introverted thinking. Than the introverted feeling. And so they're naturally going to, you know, for your ISTJs, your INTJs, they're naturally going to default to being a little bit more efficient and effective. They're not completely inconsiderate of their own feelings or their own preferences. But when it comes to, you know, a job environment, a making money environment, they're going to be able to default that extroverted thinking way of mindset, they're going to default to that extroverted thinking way of mindset, generally speaking, and tend to operate in a more effective and efficient way, but not without any consideration at all of the introverted feeling. For your ETJs, there will be a tendency to always default to what is the most effective and what is the most efficient, even when it doesn't matter. So clearly, in a job consideration, being effective and efficient matters significantly. And so that's why sometimes INFPs and ISFPs will struggle in job situations because they're so dedicated to their FI that they subjugate their TE to the degree that they're not always very effective or efficient and don't care or don't have the mental fortitude to put forth the effort to flip that and be effective and efficient. But for the ETJs, a lot of times they're going to be so effective and efficient that even in their personal lives, even in their private lives, when they're really free to do things like they want, when they're free to allow their introverted feeling to take over and have some say in the matter, they will still tend to subjugate that introverted feeling to the extroverted thinking and be efficient and effective, which sometimes can be boring, or sometimes can lead them to not really be able to have in life the things that they want because they're constantly worried about, well, I gotta focus on what needs to be done. For the ETJs and the IFPs, this divergence of way of thinking and functioning can be really difficult and detrimental. For the IFPs, it's more detrimental in those times when they need to be effective and efficient. And for the ETJs, it's more detrimental in those times when they should be free to live as they want to or do the things that bring them pleasure. For the ITJs and the EFPs, it's a little more balanced. And while there will be struggles in these areas for these people, it will not be as significant, and they will have other struggles in their life that cause them problems. I am happy to say that I have been able to subjugate in this work situation my introverted feeling to my extroverted thinking, so that generally speaking, on most runs that I take, I am driving the most effective and efficient way. Thank you, extroverted thinking. But I don't like it. So there's my introverted feeling kind of kicking back against the goads and saying, well, I'll do it, but I don't have to like it, kind of a thing. Okay, so anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this informational, entertaining, useful in some way. If you did, please click like. Please subscribe if you have not already. I just hit 1,500 subscribers, which was really cool. So thank you to all of you who have subscribed. And if you are benefiting from this channel and would see fit to do so, I would appreciate it if you would visit the website in the link or in the description below to the KOFI Coffee website, where you can make a donation to my channel if you would be so inclined. And for all of those of you who have already done that, thank you so much. I hope you guys all have an awesome day. Bye now.